A very good morning, dear children. Today we are going to see the remaining part of the chapter number 3, Properties of Natural Resources. Let us see properties of water. Let us recall some question answers. What are the states in which water is found? So water occurs in 3 states: liquid as a plain water, solid as ice, and in the gaseous state as a water vapor. What inference will you draw from the pictures alongside? So from that picture we can understood that, children, water occurs in liquid state under ordinary condition. Water is a fluid substance, means it can flow from one place to another place. Water does not have its own shape but has a volume. It can pass through small holes or seep through very small gaps or cracks. So let us see next question. On pouring water in an oil-cladded dish. Oil-cladded means, first of all, that dish was sprayed with oil. Water does not spread but forms small round drops. Why does this happen? So on pouring water in an oil-cladded dish, it doesn't spread but forms small round drops because water is less denser than oil. So the oil forms a layer on the water and forms some tiny droplets. So because of this, on the pouring water in an oil-cladded dish, there is a formation of small round drops. Now let us see properties of water. Water is a fluid substance. Fluid means it can flow from one place to another place, that is found in liquid state at room temperature and at ordinary conditions. Water has its volume but it does not have its own shape. It can seep through small holes, gaps or cracks. Means it can go from small holes, gaps or cracks also. When water freezes into ice, it expands and its volume increases. Solid ice becomes higher than the original liquid water and hence ice floats on water. Now try this. Take a plastic bottle more than half full of water. Mark the water level on the bottle. Keep this bottle upright in the freezer for making ice. Open the freezer after a couple of hours and observe. You will see that the water has changed into ice. Note the level of the ice. You will find that, children, the ice level is higher than the water level before freezing. So what can you infer from this? So from this we can understand that, children, as water freezes to form ice, it expands and its volume also increases. Now on freezing, how much was the increase in the volume of the water? In what proportion did it increase? So ice is less dense than the liquid form. So water is the only substance which can expand when it freezes. So its density decreases and it expands approximately 9% by volume. So water is expanding by 9% only, but that is related with volume only. So let us see one activity. Take a bucket of water, drop many different kinds of articles in it. Make separate list of the articles which sinks in the water and those that float on it. So after doing this experiment, we will understand that, children, the things or articles which are having light weight, they are floating on the water. Whereas the things or articles, those who are having high weight or more weight, they are sink in the water, or in short we can say they are going to the bottom of the water. Now let us see another activity. Take some water in a pot and add a few pieces of ice to it. Observe what happens. Why do we see the ice float on water? So ice is lighter than water, so when water freezes to form ice, it becomes lighter than the original liquid. So when water freezes, that is when it transforms into the solid state, its volume increases. So therefore, the density of ice is less than that of water, and that is why the ice floats on water. Now let us see one topic, that is density of water. The interrelationship between the volume and mass of a substance, that is the space occupied by a substance, is its volume. The store of matter in a substance is its mass. So how much matter is stored in that substance, that is called as its mass. And volume is nothing but that is a space occupied by a substance, that is called as a volume. And the ratio between mass and volume, that is called as density. So density is nothing but mass upon volume. So this mass we are measuring in grams and volume we are measuring in cubic centimeters. So therefore density is equal to gram per cc, means gram per cubic centimeter, and hence the unit of density is gram per cc, that is g/cc, means gram per cubic centimeter. If the mass of 1 liter of water is 1 kilogram, then what is the density of water? So 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams and 1 liter is equal to 1000 cubic centimeter. And therefore, if the water's mass is 1 kilogram, then its density will be 1 gram per cubic centimeter. So, density of water is 1 gram per cubic centimeter. Now, let us see one question. Will the mass of water change when its state changes during the transformation of liquid water into ice? So when the water changes its state during the transformation of liquid water into ice, the mass of water remains constant. The whole mass of liquid water will remain constant, but the volume of the water will change definitely because the density of ice is less than that of water. So the volume of ice will be more than that of water. Now let us see one new and important concept of this chapter, that is anomalous behavior of water. Usually when the temperature of a substance is lowered means when the temperature of a substance decreases, its density increases as its volume decreases. But water is an exception to this rule, means water is not applicable for this rule. So for this anomalous behavior of water, let us see one activity. Keep a glass full of water in the freezer for 5 to 10 minutes. Then take it out and observe it carefully. From which part in the glass does the water first start freezing? So when we are keeping a glass of water in the freezer, then the formation of ice starts from the top. Means there is a formation of ice from the top of the water only. Because when we put water at room temperature into the freezer, water starts to cool down, and that time water is cooling down. As we know, cold water is heavier, thus it settles down at the bottom, and as a result, competitively warmer water travels to the top of the container and gets cooled and again comes down. So whichever water is there, that is cold water is heavier, so that is going down. And little bit warm water is there, little bit hot water is there, that is traveling to the top of the container. And again that water is also get cooled down and again it is coming down. So this way there is a less colder water always stays at the top. Okay, and due to that whichever water is there, means that is formation of ice, that water will be at the top of the surface only, top of the surface of that container only. Now this density of water is special because when water at normal temperature starts cooling, its density increases like that of most liquids. However, if its temperature falls below 4 degrees Celsius, its density starts decreasing. This means that the density of water is maximum at 4 degrees Celsius. So we can say that, children, this density of water is maximum at 4 degrees Celsius. So if the temperature of water is lowered below 4 degrees Celsius, its density decreases and volume increases. It means that water expands when the temperature falls below 4 degrees Celsius. So we can say that, children, water is expanding when the temperature is falling between below 4 degrees Celsius. And this is called as anomalous behavior of water. Means if the temperature of water is becoming low, that is less than 4 degrees Celsius, then obviously that density decreases and volume increases. Means water is expanding when the temperature is below 4 degrees Celsius. And such type of behavior of water is called as anomalous behavior of water. Now next, use your brain power. In cold countries, how do aquatic animals remain alive even after the rivers or lakes freeze in winter? So there are some points. Let us study all these points. First point, it is possible for aquatic animals to remain alive even though rivers and lakes freeze in winter, because not the whole water bodies freezes. Means all the rivers and lakes, whole water is not becoming freeze. Okay. In cold countries, the temperature of the water body decreases, as a result of which ice is formed at the top. So when in cold countries there is a temperature very low, that time this ice is forming at the top. However, water at the bottom does not freeze up. So at the time of crisis, like freezing of river, means at the time of freezing of river, the aquatic life shifts to the bottom. Means sometimes this water is there, that is at the bottom side only this is freezing up. And what happens when this water starts freezing up? So there are some aquatic animals, so they are understanding this water, down water is not freezing up. Okay, so these animals are shifting to the bottom. So moreover, animals in these cold countries like fish are used to this weather and their surroundings so that they are able to survive regardless of the harsh temperature. And due to that, all the aquatic animals, just like fish, they are also surviving in this harsh temperature or in this cold temperature. Now let us see one activity, children. Take 2 big glasses of water. Add 4 to 5 spoonful of salt to the water in one glass and dissolve it completely. Now place a potato in the water in the second glass. The potato will sink, means that potato will go inside the bottom of the water. Take out the potato from that glass and put it in the salt water and observe. And afterwards you have to remove that potato from that normal water and you have to keep in the salty water. So the density of water in the glass is greater due to the dissolved salt. So in the B glass or in the second glass, the density of the water is more because there is a dissolved salts are there. And the potato floats in that water because of the increased density. So this potato is floating on that water because this time this density of water is more, and due to that this potato is floating in the salty water. Now next question, why is it easier to swim in the sea than in a whale or a lake? So it is easy to swim in sea water than in river water because sea water contains a large number of dissolved salts. As a result, the density of sea water is very high as compared to sea water. An object floats more in a medium which has a higher value of density than in a medium that has a lower value of density. And this is due to an increase in a beyond force in medium with higher density. So if there is a higher density of water is there, then obviously there is an increase in the buoyant force, and hence while swimming a person floats higher up in seawater than in a river water. Means that person will swim in the seawater easily than that of the lake water, because in seawater there is a presence of dissolved salts, whereas in whale or lake water there is no dissolved salt. In the above activity, the salt dissolves in the water in the glass, that it disappears. So what happens when it disappears like this? So when the salt dissolves in water, its particles spread in water. Slowly they become smaller and smaller, and all these salt particles are becoming smaller and smaller very slowly. Ultimately they become so small that they cannot be seen. That is, they mix completely with water, and that is what it is called as dissolving. Means first of all these salts are there. This salt is very small in size, that everybody knows. But afterwards it becomes smaller and smaller, and afterwards it cannot see with our naked eyes. And such type of procedure is called as dissolving. Now let us see three important concepts, that is solute, solvent and solution. So the substance that dissolved, that is called as salt. And the substance in which the solute dissolves, that is called as water. Whereas what we get when the solute dissolves in the solvent, that quantity is called as a solution. Now let us see uses of water according to its properties. Water is useful for water transport due to its fluidity. Water falling down from a height is used to generate electricity with the help of a generator. So water is falling down from a height, and due to the presence of because of this height, there is a generation of electricity with the help of generator. Water is a good coolant, means it can cool easily, and is used in motor vehicles to control the temperature of the engine. Many substances are soluble in water. Water is a universal solvent because for all purposes we required water, and due to that this water is called as a universal solvent. Water is used as a solvent in factories, laboratories, foodstuffs and in various types of biological processes occurring in the body, such as digestion, excretion, etc. Water is useful for cleaning purposes such as bathing, washing clothes, etc. So all these are the important uses of water due to their properties. Thank you children for watching the video and for your attention.